silver play button. Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. Silver play button looks so beautiful, but I don't want to look myself in the eye because I look ugly. I'm an ugly fricker, okay? You know, it's epic mullet time at the moment. My boy, epic math time, little reference here. Can go to the barber because Rona Chan, we're going to dive right in. We got another infinitely nested logarithm thing this time. It's an integral. We are going to solve it today. Let's go ahead and get started. From last nested integral thing I actually made, I got a lot of input from you guys down there in the comments. At first, I really didn't have too much of a clue how to solve this thing, but it's pretty easy, actually. I never really dealt with this type of integral before, and someone sent it to me through Twitter. This has been suggested, and yeah, I didn't know how to approach it, but after reading all of your comments down there, I basically got a huge idea of what we have to do. Let us at first take a look at this argument, this integrand. We are going to give this thing a new name. It's a function with respect to x. Let's call it f. And f is exactly what we have here, okay? F is nothing but the natural log of x minus natural log of x minus da 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 up until infinity something. It's a sequence of nested functions, okay? F is nested with itself. It's contained inside itself. If everything converges, okay, it really depends on your interval. It's an indefinite integral. Really depends what to put in there. We can actually find a recursive formula for this, okay? Do you need convergence for that? I don't know, but we are going to reassign everything. You see, f is exactly this, but f in itself is also this thing. It's just what's in the argument there, okay? So this thing here is nothing but our boy f, meaning overall, f is nothing but the logarithm of x minus f. And this is actually the proper way to assign a meaningful notation, basically, to something like this. So in normal case, you define yourself a sequence that fn plus 1 is nothing but log of x minus fn, and then you take the limit as n approaches infinity, and you are going to end up with this thing, okay? Just as a little side note, this is how you would actually give this thing a good notation. Now we can solve for s, for f, separating x in the process, and then we can differentiate, basically, to get our differential dx here, okay? Overall, what we have at the moment is nothing but the integral of f dx. This is just a function of f of x. Meaning overall, we can take the exponential function on both sides, okay? We know that e to the f power f yourself is equal to x minus f. Meaning overall, we can add f on both sides, no restrictions that we need to put on there. F plus e to the f is nothing but x. And now, like I said before, this basically acts like some kind of substitution that you can do. If you do substitutions, you basically assign a new function to the integrand and then implicitly differentiate. This acts like a simple substitution, what we have here. Meaning overall, we can differentiate both sides with respect to f, okay? X is nothing but a function of f, implicit differentiation, implicit function theorem, okay? Meaning dx, df is nothing but, well, d df of what we have here, e to the f plus f. And in one dimension, if you don't need to deal with the Jacobian, blah, 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 you actually can multiply both sides by df, or you, should we rather say we are going to apply the differential form df on both sides. If you want to solve for dx, okay, this is how substitution works, we are doing nothing but substitution, we're going to end up with d df e to the f plus f df. Well, now let us plug the new definition for our dx in, okay? We're going to get the integral of f times d df e to the f plus f df. And now, why, Baba, why didn't you differentiate this thing right here? Why do you leave it how it is? Well, because we are going to do integration by parts, and if you're a smart boy, you are going to see that this is way easier to handle then, okay? Okay? But only if you're a smart boy. Silver play button. Okay, we are going to differentiate something, we are going to integrate something. Place your bets now, up there in the poll. What are we going to differentiate and what are we going to integrate? We are going to differentiate our boy F. You might ask yourself, what's the differential of f? Well, I'll tell you this, one, because we are integrating with respect to f, okay? We have to differentiate with respect to f. So that's our boy one. And if we were to integrate a differential, well, we are just going to end up with the function that should be differentiated in the normal case, differentiated. Meaning, we are going to end up with e to the f plus f. Okay, this is why I left the differential how it is, just because we integrated it later. Meaning overall, integration by parts gives us that we are going to multiply this together. So this is going to give us f squared plus f e to the f minus those multiplied together in an integral. Minus integral of e to the f plus f, integrate with respect to f. Yeah, and now we are basically done. I mean, you guys are noobs, but you probably know how to integrate something with respect to f here, okay? We're going to get f squared plus f e to the f minus e to the f, okay, this is going to stay how it is, minus f squared over 2 plus some arbitrary constant kappa. I mean, we can add the constant after resubstituting everything. I mean, it already looks pretty ugly. We can do some more simplifications, okay? If we were to plug in our f yet again, it's just going to be really ugly, but we can do some simple simplifications. Simple simplifications. So, f squared minus f squared over 2 is going to give us f squared over 2. Also, we are going to have e to the f, so plus e to the f times f minus 1. Plus some arbitrary constant kappa out of the real numbers. Okay, actually we can do some more, I don't know if you can even call this simplifications, we can do some more spieling around, playing around with the expressions like you would play around with a girlfriend at home. Now e to the f is nothing but, so if you take a look at this definition, e to the f is nothing but x minus f in itself. Okay, so we are going to get f squared over 2 plus x minus f, f minus 1 plus kappa. And overall we are going to get f squared over 2 plus xf minus x minus f squared plus f plus kappa. Well, f squared over 2 minus f squared is going to give us negative x squared, f squared over 2. X and f sound so similar. Xf. Yes, exactly. So we are going to get x times f minus 1. And also we are going to get negative f squared over 2 plus f plus some arbitrary constant kappa. And here, this is basically it. I mean, it was just some more simplification stuff. I hope I didn't do any mistake. I mean, seems right to me. Yeah, this is how you can solve nested integrals. And you can probably plug in some values. I mean, obviously you need to resubstitute our f into here, but that would just be an absolute mess. I'm wondering if we were to plug in 1 or something, 1 would probably pose a huge problem, right? So x being equal to 1. Then, I'm just thinking about certain values. Can we even evaluate it at values? It's probably a matter of using Wolfram Alpha or MATLAB or something to actually see where it converges to. It's not an easy matter. In normal case, you need to find asymptotic formulas for stuff like this and then see if you can actually find an actual value. If we were to plug in 1, I think that wouldn't go anywhere. Also, if you would plug in 0, I have a bad feeling that it's 0. It would diverge. So probably only values between 0 and 1, strictly in between, are allowed, but I could be wrong here. No, for all other values, you would get complex solutions. Maybe someone can post it down there in the comments. How about that? Maybe that sounds good to you. If you did enjoy this video, please like, subscribe, recommend, share if you want to see more videos like this. Please tell me down there in the comments. Also, buy those t-shirts I create or support channel on Patreon. Become a channel member. And I'm at the next video. Have a play button. day. Ciao.